Hello friends, I am Bharati from www.learnlikeachildren.blogspot.com. Daily one question or passing or important question series. Today it is 6th day, I have taken 6th day question. In this video, I have taken unit triangles. In triangles, you can expect a very important question on theorems. Theorem might be basic proportionality theorem or theorem related to areas of similar triangles or Pythagoras theorem. So these three theorems are very important. Among three important theorems, today I am going to discuss the theorem on Pythagoras. So this is very important question. What I am going to show today is I'll show you how you can write or represent the theorem just in 5 minutes after learning my method here. First one. Second one is, it is guarantee question. The students who aim to score first 28 marks, that is who aim to just pass, those who are struggling in mathematics can use this method. Next, I have used a mnemonics method, which is very helpful to learn this theorem in very fun way. So let us start Pythagoras theorem. Now let us see the statement of Pythagoras theorem, which states that in a right angle triangle, square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Okay, let us remember any two words of this statement. Okay, if you ask me to suggest you two good words, I'll tell you or I would suggest you the word square, because square is the word which is very much involves in Pythagoras theorem. One more word is hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is the side opposite to right angle. Okay, these two words can help you to recall the theorem in your examination. So be familiar with these two words. Now we will divide the whole theorem, statement of the theorem, into two parts. First part would help us to draw the diagram and to derive the data, and second half would help us to draw the two proof statement. Okay, let us start. I have already drawn the diagram of right angle triangle. Okay, and right angle is here, that is 90 degrees. Okay, first let us write the data. Data is the information that we observe in the given figure or the figure that we have drawn. Fine. Okay, please observe this figure and just see what is there in the figure. I am seeing here a right angle triangle. Okay, let me write the same. A, B, C is a right angled triangle. Okay, and we have to mention where exactly the right angle is. Okay, it is at B. Then A, B, C, we have to mention where the angle is. So angle is at B, so I have put one topi on B. Okay, that is 90 degrees. Fine, data is over. Next, let me take to prove. Yes, to derive the data, I have used first half of the statement, that is in a right angled triangle. I have used this sentence, half sentence already. Now I would love to use the remaining half. That is, square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Okay, where is hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is the side which is exactly opposite to right angle. Okay, B is right angled, then opposite to B is AC. Then I have to write down AC. And square of AC, let me put a power 2 on AC. This is equal to other two sides. Which are other two sides? Yes, AB and BC are other two sides. AB and BC, they are not simply equal, but their squares are equal. Their squares are not exactly equal, but squares of squares and sum of those two sides along with their squares are equal. It means I have to put one addition sign here. This is OR to prove statement. Yes, we are ready with to prove. Next, construction. In construction, we have to draw something that is helpful to derive our conclusion or to prove statement. Okay, let me make one line, perpendicular line, I can say. This perpendicular line BD, and this line is perpendicular to AC. Okay, let me write the same. Draw BD perpendicular to AC. Okay, our construction is also over now. But before going to proof, let me give you one small mnemonics. As I have already told you that I will be giving you mnemonics throughout the theorem to learn the same. Okay, let me discuss that mnemonics. You just suppose that there is one small town. Okay, this is our small town. In this town, one river. That is one river, and this river is flowing in between the town. It means this river is dividing the town exactly into two parts, and let us call these two parts by one cute name, that is baby. First half is baby one and second half is baby two. Is it not cute? Yeah. And the whole town as mom. Okay, fine. Now the river divides these two, divides the town into two parts, that we know. And those two parts are very similar in resemblance. They are very similar to each other. They are not only similar to each other, but they are also similar to their mom. It means baby one, baby two, and mom. These three small towns are similar to each other. Obviously, their size is different. Their sizes are because mom has bigger area, but babies have smaller area, but still their shape is same. Because of that, we call them as similar, right? Whenever we need to use this information, definitely we would use that. Next, one more thing is there before going to the proof. Let me explain you. Suppose here anyway we have called the bigger town as mom, right? First mom, what she will do? She will select a line for her and she will select a different line for her baby. But in the second turn, she will give her line to her baby and she will go for next. This is the policy of this mom. Let us use that trick also in proving this Pythagoras theorem, because I have already told you that I will be giving you many tricks so that you can remember Pythagoras theorem in a very fun way. Is that not true? Yeah, I am giving you fun facts also. Let us use this fun fact in presenting this Pythagoras theorem. Okay, let us move to proof. Now let us see the last part of the theorem, that is proof. Okay, yeah. In proof, we have already divided this triangle as baby 1, this is baby 2, and the whole triangle is mom, right? Accordingly, we will use the triangles. Fine. Let us start. Now, let me consider two triangles. One, the baby triangle, and the second one is mom. Okay, let me write. The triangle ABD, that is baby triangle, similar to mom, that is triangle ABC. Why these two triangles are similar? The reason is, already we have discussed in the story of a town, that is BD is a perpendicular drawn from right angle B to AD, hypotenuse AD. It is just like a story. A line BD divides the triangle ABC into two similar triangles. Okay, these two triangles are similar to ABC. It means this line, perpendicular line BD, divides the whole triangle into two parts. Already we know that. And those two parts are similar. Those two parts, they are in turn similar to their mom, that is ABC. That is the reason. You have to remember these two to three lines and practice them. Just if you learn them once, you can use it in the theorem twice. Okay? Yeah. Now, these two triangles are similar. By similarity property, we have to write the ratios. For the ratios, first let me consider the baby triangle. In baby triangle, baby has got this sign, this side, that is AD. AD. And mom has decided to take AB. Yes. Next step, what happens? Mom gives its side to its baby. So now AB moves to baby side. Like baby has taken this side now. First it was mommy's side, but now it is baby's. Okay, AB. And now mom has moved to another side, that is she has decided to take AC. AC is nothing but hypotenuse. Here is AC, you just see, this is AC. Okay, now mom has shifted herself to AC. Fine. Now just you make a cross multiplication, AB into AB equals AD into AC. As AB is repeated, AB into AB, I would consider it as AB square is equal to AD into AC. Now we can call it as 1. Similarly, now we will take another half or baby number 2, that is BDC, triangle BDC. This is similar to mom. Mom is ABC. Okay? When they are similar, simply we can write their ratios. Okay? First, mom baby has selected DC, this prime, this side. Mom has taken BC. Okay? DC divided by BC. DC divided by BC, which is equal to, now mom, she has given her side to her baby. It means now BC belongs to baby. Let me write BC. And mom shifted herself to AC. Okay, let me write here AC. Otherwise, if you don't understand this mnemonics also, you can just write, once you finish off with BC, again you start the next ratio with BC. Okay, now we will cross multiply them. Okay, now BC into BC, which is equal to DC into AC. Now as BC is repeated, I would write them as BC square. DC into AC, as it is, call it as 2. Next step is add 1 and 2. Let's see what happens after adding 1 and 2. As they are not numerics, there is no necessary to really add the things. You just write them by putting addition sign. That's all. Okay. Let me write first as it is. It means AB square is equal to AD into AC. Similarly, BC square is equal to BC into AC. Okay. After adding, what I would get is AB square plus BC square, because I have added these two things. Similarly, I have added RHS, right hand side, that is AD into AC plus DC into AC. One thing is common, that is AC. You just remove AC out of this set. Write like this, AC comes out of the bracket, AD plus DC remains as it is. Now let's see what is the meaning of AD plus DC. Come to the figure. AD means from A to D, DC means D to C. Instead of moving from A to D, D to C, I would directly try to move from A to C. It means instead of writing AD plus DC, I can directly write AC. Okay, already one AC is there with us. Now I am writing one more AC in the bracket. Okay, there are two ACs now. It means AC square. In left hand side, I will continue with the same and write AB square plus BC square. See, our proof is ready. So in this way, you can write the proof. If you practice it for one or two times, definitely you will master it, no doubt. And it is easiest method, I think. Okay friends, now for today's session, it is enough. If you like this video, you just give thumbs up. Please share this video with your friends. And please do subscribe my channel so that I can send you my upcoming videos notifications. Until then, take care. Bye.